So I'm in one of the low. Okay, so this might be a trap. No, it's not. So I'm in one of the lowest levels of this chalice dungeon. I'm trying to beat all the chalice dungeons to unlock the final boss. And I hear you get like a really good gem to upgrade my to like sock it into my gear and shit. So I'm doing that now. I've never been this deep into it before. Okay, that room looks dangerous. And I want to try to get all the achievements. I got like 50% achievements. So let's see how far I can go with it. Alright, 1 second. I just got an email. Let me check the email for work. Anything important? I get emails all day. I just finished my job for today, but I sent out an important question to my coworker, and no, they didn't respond. They don't know how to. I don't think they know how to do it. The question that I had. So yeah, I work as a programmer, and I've been working as a programmer now for a while. Wait. So 2009, I moved. Oh, that's a bad guy. So, I moved here. I live in Europe, so I moved to Europe. I'm originally from America. Moved to Europe in 2009. Whoa. And 2017 now. So, that's 6 years, and I was working, before I came here for about 2 years, so about 7 years, maybe 7 years I've been working as a programmer. I'm definitely mid-level. I guess you call me senior level. But, I don't know, you know, I really don't give a shit about titles, you know, after so many years of work, you know, you don't have really have an ego anymore about it, you know. Whoa, that might actually get me in the corner. Can I adjust the settings of the microphone and make it louder for you? Let me see. Settings, audio sharing settings. No. I can't. I can lower the volume of the game. Okay. On my TV. I don't wonder if you see that. If you see my TV. That should be better. Okay, so there's 1, 2. Let me see. What kind of room is this? Okay, this is. Alright, so I'm gonna run in. I should come in out of. Okay, there's 2 of them. Path down. Okay, easy. Okay, so I'll do this. This is a 2-floor room where it looks like there's guys on the top and the bottom. I could probably one-shot him. Whoa! Fuck. What? Oh, his running guy got me. He melee did it though. Yeah, so I get emails throughout the day. I just did about a 9-hour shift. I work from home, so I get to walk in the other room and play some Bloodborne after I'm finished. You know, I still answer issues and stuff. I set them up. But I don't get to, I don't have to go into the office every day. You know, I used to do that. I really don't like it. I prefer work from home. Whoa. I forgot that. Where is he? There he is. So yeah. So yeah, my day is pretty much, I get up and I do some work. I do a full day's work, and then I play some Bloodborne when I'm done. You know, but I need to be around because if something might come up, I need to be here to fix it. So you're kind of like always on call as a software engineer. Alright, so. Yeah, so you're pretty much always on call, kind of like a doctor would be on call if an issue, if an emergency comes up. Come on, little guy. Come on. Now you're dead. Yeah, so each one of these rooms is like a little puzzle. It's pretty cool. I like it. A puzzle to the respect that, you know, you try to get into the room and you try not to get hit. You know, you gotta take out the mobs in a certain order. I remember, which one was that? Metal Gear Solid 2, I think, on PlayStation 2. Was like that when you have to kill the guys in a specific order in the room to get all the dog tags to without being seen, because you have to like knock them out and do it. So there was a kill order you had to do. So this is very similar to that with a kill order. This is the chest. Is this the kind that doesn't eat? I think there's two kinds of these squid heads. One that that tries to like suck your what is it called? The your insight, tries to suck your insight away. Great Lake. And there's another one that looks like this is the other one, that just tries to just melee you. What does Great Lake do? Oh shit, man, an upgrade. Nice. Definitely use that. Every little bit counts, 1% more. So it was worth it doing all this. And that was a straight upgrade for me. So 1% on all attacks, that's pretty useful. You know? I am noticing that in a PvP, I kind of get one-shotted. You know? Well, the times I did get one-shotted was when it was a 2v1, and they surrounded me. You know, that wasn't really that fair. But, you know, I'm invading their game. I can't expect them to be fair. So yeah, you know, when you do that, you open the door up for anything goes, really. So I really don't mind. You know, I kill people too with a 2v1 if I have a chance, just like they do it to me. So there's nothing wrong in that. It's all a fair game. Okay, so I came from here, and this is the boss. So I really have no idea what this boss is. I never did this one before. Okay. So this is a level 3 boss, it looks like, but I can't summon. I don't think it's Amidala, because Amidala usually gives you someone to summon. This is the fourth category is Chalice. A level 5 dungeon. This is a root dungeon. Not a normal. Okay, let's see what we got here. This is pretty easy. Pretty easy. Oh shit, I was right. I'm a god. Wow, I didn't do this without help. And it's dark. Alright, so I've done this so many times. I've actually done this with the curse debuff. With half health, see, that would have killed me. So, like, I pretty much know this fight. Like, the back. There was an open room. I wonder how I can leverage this. Come on. Something that big, you would think they could destroy that building. Turn the Amidala, we'll use the vomit. I made so many videos of Gift Amidala, she killed me so many times. go around this way. Final room, definitely. I think this is going to give me the final item to reach like the last level. So I think you fight like Miss Yarnum or something. I don't know. Let me see if I get some help with this. Maybe they kick the helper away and put the pillars in, try to balance it out. Nobody's watching. I don't mind. I'm gonna put these up on YouTube anyway, so it's all good. Yes, I started doing reviews also on my channel, and it's cool. It's really cool. I really enjoy doing reviews. I used to like growing up, because I grew up in like the 80s, 90s. You know, we didn't have the internet back then, and basically just word of mouth. I would call up my friend Jay. I would call Joe. You know, we would say, "Oh, hey, wow, this game is really cool." You know, I remember when I rented Resident Evil 1, and my friend was telling me about that. You know, you gotta try this game out. So really doing these reviews is like, you know, reliving my childhood in the sense that I get to go and just like talk about the games that I play, but I get to talk about it to you guys, you know, not just one or two friends. I didn't really have that many friends that play video games, only like one or two. I get to talk to, I mean, as many as I can, hopefully hundreds of thousands. You know, that would be really cool, you know, to have like a nice little community all chatting and stuff. Let me try this again. I'll recover this first. mean, really, I make videos mostly for just a sort of hobby. You know, I watch a lot of videos online. Like, I first watched all of Angry Video Game Nerd. He's what got me into it. I've seen every one of his videos. And then, I started seeing Angry Joe. I don't know, Angry Joe's alright. His Cobra Commander is very funny. But, I don't know, it's okay. I mean, it's not amazing. It's good. Okay, I like that game. No Man's Sky was funny. No Man's Sky was really funny. It depends on the game. I mean, really, it depends on what material you give him. He's an actor, really. I see him as an actor. You know, not so much as a critic. Although he does do critiques, but, you know, he's okay. I like Worth a Buy more, because what I don't like about Joe is he's politically correct. You know, to the sense that he just says what he thinks that you want to hear and what's popular. Worth a Buy doesn't give a shit. Max just does not give a shit. Okay? And the same thing with, what's his name? Jim Sterling, I also like. Actually, I like controversial people more. I think they're real. They're the most genuine people. But that's kind of how I am, too. I'm pretty honest. You know, I just tell it like this. I don't give a shit if it makes them happy or not. It's my chance, really, so, you know. To survive, it would be nice. This is all I did. But no, I don't need it to survive. So I can pretty much run it any way I want. You know? Oh, come on. So yeah. So pretty much I give you my unapologetic opinion. So yeah, this is not a safe space. It's not not politically correct. It's you know, it's just like just real. You know, it's real. It's the best way I could say. Very genuine, very real. No bullshit. You know, just straight up. It is what it is. You know. It's not fluff, you know. I guess the more people that you reach, you know, the more watered down you try to become. But I don't know. You gonna jump now? Flashbacks of Resident Evil. Which is great. I love those games, you know. I haven't had a good game like that. They don't make games that anymore. You know? So, yeah, I told you guys I'm a programmer. My plan is one day when I stay in the office, I don't have to work anymore. I'm going to make video games. Okay? Maybe I could do something with... I mean, I could program from scratch, okay? But if I use an engine, like Unreal or something, it might be even much faster to do it. But I, you know, I've made games from scratch before. I made a Pokemon game in college from scratch. Nothing, you know, I don't use engines. So, you know, I program my own collision detection, my own animation, everything. But comparing RPG Maker to comparing running it himself, I didn't use RPG Maker. Okay? RPG Maker is unacceptable for software engineering. I actually wrote the code and everything. In fact, from nothing, I didn't use Visual Basic. So that was the one that was hot before about that. We need another programmer in the class. He did the busy work, the grid based stuff. So I need the edges of each structure in the game. So there's doors or cabinets and stuff. I didn't know where it was today, right? The X mark warned it. So he would spend the time and record all that. So it was very easy to So I wound up making like a Pokemon style, like more of a Dragon Ball style. But they're really the same. 2D sprites, basically. Casino. I have no idea where it is. But nowadays, I can kind of think of a new role. I wouldn't make it from scratch because I'm aware of all the tools that exist now. I didn't know about things like Unreal or Source Engine, I didn't even know what that was. I guess it was out of the game? Only games weren't really that popular back then. Kind of thing. So common. So common. It's like Final Fantasy 11. But PC gaming, what do you think? What was popular at that time? Call of Duty was offline at the moment. There was no online Call of Duty. It did not exist. Battlefield was around. Battlefield 1942 was around. It was around. I remember that. But I don't know what that was doing. Well, if anybody watching this, you guys know what engine Battlefield 1942 is in, comment below. I'm eating away my potions more than I'm doing. Oh. You gotta attack it from an angle to get his arm. Got him. Finally, a visual attack. Whoa. I've never done that before. Come on! Oh, this would be so easy, it would help. Whoa, 16 emails I got just in that time. Let me see. Anything do I need to look at? Let's call for help. No. It looks okay. Waiting for a second. I don't think anybody's gonna come. I wonder if there's someone I can summon. Okay. Where the fuck did it go? It jumped? So I love the combat in this game, really. It keeps me coming back to these Dark Souls games. The combat is so satisfying. And it just feels right. It feels so good, the combat. I don't know what happened to him. Where did he go? Well, I got enough points now to buy potions. Let me do that. I'm gonna buy stock up on potions. Amadala. Oblongata, I don't know what it is, but it's a pain in the ass. Maybe someone will come now. This is a root dungeon, I think. Let's see. Yeah, it is a root, because I could what do you call it? I can invade. I wonder, where is he? Where was that werewolf? Try this boss again. So I've killed this boss before, I've killed him a bunch of times, but I've always had an NPC helping me, or a player helping me, never by myself, and they're not giving me that option at this time. So let me try it again. Watching. Sorry for the low quality, but using the connection I have, this quality is stable video. It's not bad. Try to kill him, hit him more than I hear. Just to be ahead on life. I should kill him. This, in my opinion, this boss is one of the hardest. Yeah, easily one of the hardest. Because he just has a bunch of different... He has a really weird hitbox. Aquaman. Thank you. okay, I'm a bothered right now, but I can't get one shot. I can't get out of the city, but nice. This will attack. Okay. Come on, are you kidding me? So dead if I had just someone fighting it for a minute, 1 minute, it would have been dead. Just distracted a little bit. Not even, 30 seconds would have been enough. So yeah, while these chalice dungeons are pretty fun, I enjoy the handmade stages much more. This is just, you just get to just play around with the combat. It's fun, you know? It's a grindy area. But without a doubt, my favorite is just doing these custom-made areas. Neo has some really good stages. This new Japanese Souls-like game. That one is pretty cool, but Bloodborne is nice. Neo I think is better. Dark Souls 2 and 1. I haven't played 3 so much. I have it on my PS on Steam, but I haven't gotten around to it yet. I want to beat this first. I got really close last time, but if I had just one more person helping me, I don't think anybody's helping, because there's nobody here. Yeah, they don't come to these stages, really. You don't see anyone. my own, on my own. Alright. Let's try it. Alright, let's see. Do I have any items that can help me with this? Poison knives won't hurt. Okay. Oh, I see it's touching me. Okay, let's try this again. This game reminds me of a time when I got, beautiful. When I got Chrono Trigger. Oh, in that game. That was a fucking masterpiece. Even when I got it, I knew it. It was so incredible. Really. They don't make games like that anymore. I don't understand. It wasn't the combat alone that made it so good. The combat was great, no doubt. But it was the story which was interesting. Going through time and how things change and stuff. It was just so cool. Thank you. games are great. Video games, a lot of games. So another thing I really felt like I missed out on, what do you call it? Warhammer 40K. The miniature tabletop game. I feel like I missed it. Maybe because I lived in Brooklyn. I've never even seen anyone play it. No one who knows about nobody was playing it. We played the Magic the Gathering this thing. Played Pokemon, that was good. Yu-Gi-Oh! All the card games. Okay. So, never any of the tabletop games. But I did it for Pokemon Magic the Gathering, I was playing. The two arms. Yeah, so the tabletop games, I really never, I wanted to play. I saw them briefly at some place. You know where I saw it? I went to this place in Manhattan that had it, and they were doing very very low scale. So you can imagine in New York City, you would think they would have these things. No, they don't. They really don't have a lot of stuff there. They really don't. Unless you gotta really, really know where to look. In New York City, but I was in Brooklyn, and Brooklyn it doesn't have all the things that you would imagine. So yeah, I kinda missed out. Me and my friends, we play Magic a lot, but Never Warhammer. Also, Warhammer is kind of expensive to get into. If you get into Dungeons and Dragons, and play that, that's also expensive, but I actually got a book, I actually stole a book from the school library. I actually have that in place. The players, the Dungeon Masters, I think that's for them. I still have it. It's in the other room. It's in an old edition. To this boss, and make you look way harder than it really is. I played Magic before. I had the general idea of how to play card games. I was okay. I was okay at it. You know, they had some of the best players in the world in Magic the Gathering. I never won a tournament. I never even came top three in Magic. I never won any prizes in Magic the Gathering. At all. So you can imagine how difficult some of the people are to play that game where I play. They're a little difficult. closer every time, but it's hard. Okay, that's enough. 60,000. That should be enough for, I think, 60 of them. More than that. Maybe it's actually about 70. 70 potions. Checking my email. Nothing. Work. 60. Okay, I gotta go to the other room for a moment. Let me end this now. I'll do another video later. Thanks for watching.